there, and welcome. Today's guided meditation is for those of you who struggle with aphantasia. This is, in other words, the inability to form mental images voluntarily in the mind. I personally have struggled with this in my meditation journey, and I now have some tips and tricks I'd like to share with you, as well as trauma-informed theories as to why this may be happening for you. So if you're interested in any of that, then keep watching. But first, a quick message from today's sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by Afterglow. I think it's safe to say that every single one of us craves connection, but it's not always easy to get that. If you have a story to tell and you need a safe space to share it, Afterglow is the place to do that. Afterglow is an app where you can find your people. It is a place where you can speak your heart out, read and listen to others with beautiful ambient music to help you calm your mind and relax. So I'm a sucker for lo-fi music, and I love that you can listen to it while you navigate your requests. There's a sense of warmth and openness. I think it's a huge bonus also to be able to send voice messages and connect with somebody's energy that way. You can choose between different areas of interest, such as relationships, dreams, ASMR, and LGBT+. Download Afterglow using the link in the description box or scan the QR code right over here. Meet new people and discuss things that are important to you with ones who understand. First off, I want to ask you, if you're currently struggling with aphantasia, are you also struggling to recall certain memories? And with the memories that you can recall, do you struggle to feel the associated emotions? I ask this because if you find it difficult to create mental images, if you find it difficult to recall memories, and if you find it difficult to conjure up past emotions, this can all be a sign of a weak mind-body connection. And that just means your mind finds it difficult to pick up signals from the subconscious, stored information, stored energy from the body, the subconscious. And don't worry, the mind-body connection is very malleable. And it's something that you can definitely improve very quickly. Also, this just tells us that you may have had traumatic experiences in the past that led you to believe that it's not safe to be connected to the body or to feel emotions and sensations. And you most likely still have unresolved trauma to work through, and that's okay. Strengthening the mind-body connection will get you there. And what I would recommend for you to strengthen this connection are body-focused therapies and modalities. So somatic experiencing, somatic meditations, active meditations, humming, chanting, body scans, tensing and releasing your muscles, getting active, these sorts of things will really help you. And another thing I want to add is, perhaps you're just not a visual learner. And that's totally fine. I don't think I'm a visual learner. You have four other senses that you can use to perceive reality. It doesn't all have to be visual when you meditate. You can use your ability to sense sound and touch and all of these, and smell and taste, to visualize. And that is exactly how we're going to visualize in this meditation. So if you are ready now, I know I said a lot. If you are ready, I'd like you to sit in a comfortable position. Just make sure you're relaxed. It's so important to be relaxed. So relax, get into the most comfortable position ever. And from there, you're just going to loosen up. You can even tense and release your muscles if you like. So let's do that together. You can tense your fists, tense your feet, toes, curl your feet up, tense your face, and then release. Shake it off if you like. Now you can just melt. Melt into your body. Whichever way you're seated or lying down, just melt into your body. And whenever you're ready, whenever you feel safe enough to do so, you can close your eyes and sigh. Meditation should be relaxing, right? We meditate to feel better, to feel more centered, more calm, more relaxed. So start off by actually relaxing your body. Relax the forehead. Relax the eyebrows. Relax the nose. Relax the cheeks. Relax the lips. And allow your face to just melt. Let go. Allow your face to melt. And then relax the neck. It's going to feel as if your neck is getting longer and longer. Relax the neck. And then you're naturally going to want to loosen up your shoulders. Drop the shoulders because you're letting go. There's nothing to hold on to. Drop the shoulders. And then feel gravity pulling your arms down. Your arms are relaxing. Your hands are relaxing. And your fingers are relaxing. And all of this is happening without you having to do anything. You don't have to try to relax. You just relax. It just happens. So don't worry, you're doing amazing. You're actually doing really well. I promise you. Now, relax the chest and the stomach by taking some deep breaths into the torso. Expand as you breathe in and exhale, breathe out. Breathe in, chest, belly rises. Breathe out, chest, belly falls. Breathe in, chest, belly rises. Breathe out, chest, belly falls. And now, bring your awareness down, down, down to the legs. Relax the legs. Loosen up the legs and keep moving down, down, down to the feet. Relax the feet. Doing really well. Take a deep breath in now and sigh out of your mouth. Relax even more. Just going to melt into your seat. Just relax. I want to remind you that you are safe. You are safe in this moment. You are allowed to relax and feel comfortable in your body. You're allowed to feel comfortable. You're safe. And you're doing really well. There's no right or wrong way to do any of this. Meditation is a practice, and the fact that you're here is already incredible. You're doing so well. From here, you don't have to try to do anything. You don't have to force yourself to do anything. There's nothing you should do. I invite you to just be curious. Just be curious. You can follow my voice and follow my suggestions if it sparks interest. Here's my first suggestion. I'd like you to feel as if your water flowing down a gentle stream. But I want you to feel like your water. You don't have to see the stream. Feel it. What does moving water feel like to you in this moment? Can you imagine? There's no right or wrong answer to this. We all feel differently. Imagine water flowing downstream, flowing down, down, down. Water flowing down, down, down. Water flowing, trickling down, down. Down. Do you hear the water? Water flowing down, trickling down, down, down. feels like surrendering and going with the flow, doesn't it? Allowing gravity and the stream to shape you as you let go, surrender, and flow. I'd like you to go back to a pleasant, happy, blissful, and safe experience. You don't have to try to remember anything. You can just go back, allow the water to take you and flow back, 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 back. Flow back, 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 back. Just flow back, 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 back. Until blissful sounds, smells, sensations, and tastes come to you. Go all the way back. Until these wonderful sensations arise. How did you feel on that beautiful day? How did you feel in your body? Did you feel light in your chest? When you're happy, you tend to feel that way, don't you? Did you feel grounded? When you feel safe, you tend to feel that way, don't you? Did you feel energized? Or maybe relaxed and calm? What did you feel in your body in such a beautiful day? In such an expansive experience that made you feel so, so good. Now, if you'd like, notice if you hear any sounds from that day. Maybe sounds of nature. Maybe sounds of loved ones. Maybe you smell something. Smell of your mother's perfume. Freshly baked cookies. What do you smell? Maybe you feel things at your fingertips and against your skin. Your clothes that day touching your skin, or the feeling of the cabinets against your fingertips. Enjoy everything you're sensing in this moment. Wonderful. You're doing so, so well. You see, visualizing does not have to just be about seeing things. Visualizing is so much more, because in the mind's eye, you can recall past and potential future experiences using your senses, and that includes your ability to hear, touch, smell, and taste. So moving forward, I invite you to visualize this way whenever you're asked to focus on your other senses and what that memory felt like. You don't have to see it, you just have to feel it. Feel it to tap into the energy of it. Of course, remember to always relax before meditating, relax before any healing modality. Remind yourself often that you're safe, that everything is okay, there's no right or wrong, and you're doing really, really well. Let's take 3 deep breaths to let all of that sink in. Breathe in. And let that sink in. Breathe in. Sink in. Deep breath in. And let it sink in. Breathe out. Wonderful. Now, I'm going to count from 10 to 1. You can use this countdown to drift off into sleep. You can also use it to awake. The choice is yours. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Thank you so much for being here and meditating with me. We reached the end of this video, but I will see you very soon.